Hey there, hope you're doing good. As we continue our refactoring of Futurecam, today we'll work on extensions. Specifically, the problem we have is some extensions are stored in files with the name class plus something like AV asset plus util. Some of them are stored in files like core graphics. Core image. Always typing CI image here. So yeah, let's try to make it consistent. And I also got a warning about this file being bigger than 400 lines. So let's try to split some of these into different extensions. Let's see how it goes. We could split this into three files: AV asset writer, AV asset writer input, AV asset writer input pixel buffer adapter. We'll park this and come. Revisit it in a while. These extensions are subtypes of AV capture device. So I suppose it's okay to put it here. Let's leave this as well. We can revisit it. This has only one. This doesn't have much. This has only appropriate stuff. Ooh, global variable. Let it search. It has a helper class, but the helper class is used only by this extension. It's okay. If you were to move it out, its access will increase, which we don't want. Are we using this art anywhere? Here we are. Yeah. Okay, let's go ahead and make the change. If it doesn't work, we can always split it. And we can always undo it without committing. Because some of these things, unless you do it, you can't be sure. I hope they are not accessing file private things. AV Foundation is Apple's framework for audio and video. Now we'll need to create another extension with this gigantic. Where is array? Oh, array is the first one. Next, we need one on collection. Not collections, but collection. Okay, we'll get to it. We'll need one on dictionary. Then we'll need one on CF dictionary. This should be collection. CG size. Next, we need CG point. Even though it may be a little overkill to have a separate file for one extension with one function with one line of code, if you maintain consistency, it's easier to find any extension based on the class name, like CG point. If not, you'll have to look at, is it in CG, is it in core graphics plus UI, is it somewhere else. Now we need one on CG rect. one on CGA fine transform. One improvement we are making is here we have imported UIKit, whereas here we are importing core graphics. UIKit indirectly imports core graphics, but better to import only what you want, not everything. This is just CG rec now. Okay, let's split this to CI context. CI stands for core image. You don't need an IIFE here. Now you have CI image. These are all CI image functions. Don't know whether you need all of these, but right now I don't want to play this game without the comp. Let's look at this blend function. Sorry for that. Here you are blending a core image buffer. This makes sense. Image buffer is again a core image buffer. Yeah, never mind. This should again change. CM time and CM sample buffer. Import core media I'm importing core video because we are using core video CV here. Okay. This is now CM time. Yeah, this has to be split CV pixel buffer pool. Let's create one extension. Analytics. Okay, need to do import Firebase Analytics. This needs some documentation. It is CV pixel buffer, not core video. Apple has so many of these frameworks: AV Foundation, Core Image, Core Video, Core Media. They call V Image, Video Toolbox. Many of the learning curve. Numeric, clearly this needs to be split. Oh man, do I really need this? Conventions. Binary floating point and binary integer. In a way, it's good because when you split it out, you know from the file what it has rather than it being a dumping ground for various numeric things. When I say numeric, I don't know what it now this has become just binary integer. This is another dumping ground. Okay. We'll get to it. I think there are multiple date parsing routines. If you look at it, I think it's good to centralize all of them in one place. Okay, we'll get to it later. So permissions, what should we do with this? Feels a bit excessive because all of them are similar. Actually, I think you should extend from a custom string convertible. Otherwise, this doesn't do much by itself. Okay, we'll park this. Here, bunch of things, PH photo library extension is there. I'm just wondering if we split it out and some of them call the others. Then they can no longer be file prep. No, nothing is file prep here. Okay, cool. Let's first, okay, PH fetch result, PH photo library. This is PH photo library. Can keep it as it is. PH fetch result can go to another. So when you fetch something from the photo gallery, the result data type is PH fetch result. Now you need a PH asset extension. You need to split this extensions directory into multiple subdirectories. So now the problem will arise that this perform changes function is a private one. So I think even earlier the code had a problem. So now this refactoring has increased the access level of this. I don't know whether that's a good or a bad idea. Let me do this. Let me notes. I'm doing random. So PH fetch result. No changes. Let's delete these two files for now. The other change we need to make it work is make this file private. Now these functions can invoke the perform changes. Yeah, I'm not too sure about this file. Let's leave it. Escape product is straightforward. Swift store kit is straightforward. UI, yeah. Files. Was the thing I pasted UI color. I think all the transformation code should be in one file. Anyway. This UI control plus what? Event. A UI control represents any UI element that you can tap, like a button or a checkbox. It does not include labels and things like that, which are visual but not tappable. They're not controls. This one animation duration, we'll need to put into some other file. Okay, we'll worry about that later. With this commit, let's focus on file names alone. You have these global constants that are put in random places. Yeah, this is the thing I was talking about. We'll think about this later. Okay. Escape. the store kit extension, don't we? Escape product. What's it called? Like escape payment state. Import store kit. Oh, another dumping ground. Happy we are finding all this junk. Look at util.swift. Util is the ultimate dumping ground, isn't it? NS object protocol. See more dumping ground constant. File manager. I'm happy we are cleaning up this mess eventually. It just becomes hard to find what you want. Oh, foundation, not file manager. Oh my god, some more. Notification. So there are two ways to organize this. One is just based on the class which we are using here. The other is based on some kind of logical purpose like this. All the permission related things in one place. But pick one and stick with it. So I think that's a reason for breaking this up into 3-4 separate extensions and separate files. Now these global constants should really go for the file. We have two extensions on UI interface orientation. Okay, we'll get to this later. This is not really an extension as such, like syntactically it's an extension, but it defines some functionality related to mode, so we can leave it here. Oh, let's look at these tips. We'll take quite a lot of. I think these are used only for debugging. But you could argue it's such a basic thing that it could be used for anything. Anyway, never mind. This extension has been made file private because everything in it is private to this file. The elements have come here. AV asset writer dot util, sorry, dot swift has lost all of the others. They have been moved to asset writer input. Asset writer input pixel buffer adapter. Was this Apple engineer paid by the for each letter he put in this file name? This has been made let, binary floating point, binary integer, bool. Is asint even used? I don't think. I remember removing the code that you. CGF dictionary, CGFI transform, GPoint, CGRect, CGSize, CI context, CI image, CM sample buffer. CM time collection. Pixel buffer, AV pixel buffer, bool, dictionary, error, file manager, extension, notification, NS object protocol, PH photo library. Escape payment state, UI color, UI. UI interface orientation, util. Yeah, we should really call this global constants. That's what it is. We'll do that in a future commit, I guess. second item is done. We'll work on this in the next video. Great, I think we're done with this video. See you in the next one.